Hello there, one and all. This is NDM here. Welcome you back to another episode of Let's Play Mother 25th Anniversary Edition. Okay, so in the last episode, we cleared out the ghost house in Halloween, and I did mention in the last episode that we're going to be making our way back to Marysville to head out to the desert, because that's where our next destination is. I also took the courtesy to go off screen and actually find my way back out of the ghost house, because I didn't want to show that whole process on screen, because that would just take up time, and there's no point in seeing things that you've already seen before, and encountering, like, enemies we've already seen before, and, you know, because that'll just take up too much time. I also emptied out the inventory for Lloyd, and emptied out the inventory for Anna to a significant amount, because we need to have free inventory space, because we need to buy flight plan tickets, and, basically we need to use those tickets as, proof, I guess, or basically we need to cash them in for the tank that we need to use in the desert to access a certain area there. There's like these ruins you have to go ahead and explore, but you need the tank to kill this really powerful monster to get inside. It's basically a giant robot. I think it's called R037, I think that's what it's called. Need to find our way back out of here. We're going to be running into quite a lot of enemies along the way, but I might as well keep these battles in because we need some battle action for this video. But I can guarantee you we'll be encountering quite a lot of enemies out in the desert, and some really powerful ones too. Also for both Lloyd and Anna. Yeah, Anna should actually be gaining a level pretty soon, I think. Alright, let's get out of here. It shouldn't take us that long to get to the train station, surely. But you won't encounter any wild enemies out in this terrain here, because this is all part of the town. It's not like Marysville, where you can go outside the town and find wild encounters. And it wasn't like that really in, well, it wasn't like that at all in, Reindeer. And this is the abandoned side of town, so you will encounter enemies out around here, but you won't encounter any enemies in the interior of the actual main town, so, yeah. I hope this red snake doesn't run away before I get to kill it, because I really need to get some good, decent experience. I guarantee it's going to run away on this turn, though. Yeah, frick's sake. And I told myself in the last video to use PK Beam when you get the opportunity, and I still didn't take my own advice in that situation. Now watch me freaking take 10 minutes to try and find the train station, and as I was about to say that, we managed to find the train tracks, so let's go in here and board the train back home to Marysville. Can't promise the train will go far, but you still gotta pay. Are you gonna ride the train? Hell yeah. Wait, it's not called Marysville, it's called Santa Claus? They're named after, like, festive seasons, or, like, they're named after a holiday of a certain time. Mother's Day is a town, which is Podunk, and now Santa Claus is, Marysville. Well, they still kept Snowman as Snowman, and Reindeer as Reindeer. But then you got a town called Easter as well, so they're naming them after the festive holidays, I guess. And, I guess Easter is obviously Ele, or L.A., Yeah, I had to listen to that song one last time, because that's going to be the last time we'll be boarding that train, because we won't be needing to go to any of those towns ever again. we've pretty much done everything we need to do in those towns. Right, so instead of going the way to Marysville, you have to come this way to the right-hand side of the train station and make your way up this terrain up here. Follow the cliffside, and this path will basically take you out to the desert. If I can get around these trees, that is, and also run into a wild encounter, obviously, and we're met with a bear. Okay, these guys aren't as powerful as the polar bears, so don't worry about these. I don't know. You know what? Screw it. Just for safety measure, I'm going to use beam beta instead of using freeze beta. Always go with your gut instinct. Yeah, that did 76 HP damage, so that's good. At least I put that spell to good use. Alright, okay, let's go around this way, because up there is a dead end. And this is also a dead end. What the hell? This is the way to the desert, right? I'm pretty sure it is, unless I've changed it in this version to get out to the desert. I might have put a different path, which would kind of be a little bit confusing. There is a broken bridge, but that bridge is always broken. You can't get, like, some carpenters to come along and fix the bridge for you, so... I mean, wouldn't that suck if that's exactly what you have to do? You have to speak to a specific person to get the bridge fixed, and that's how you get out of this hellhole. Oh, wait, no, we found it, I think. Yeah, this is it. So you go down here, and this should take you straight out to the desert. Foresty area, and here we go, yay, we found our way, right, cool. Let's play in the desert music, that it plays in Earthbound, on the way to Foreside. So if you check these bones, I think they say something, but you have to use telepathy to actually speak to them. Or do you just talk? Oh, okay, you don't use telepathy, you just talk to it. You're on Gutsy Kid, talking to dead bodies. Well, you would think that telepathy would work on those things, because it's like, you know, you're talking to them through the void between being alive and being dead. Alright, let's set the sign. Advent Desert. Why not take a sightseeing flight? Alright, so we found the flight plan location, so we're going to speak to this guy. And he's going to give us, basically, he's going to give us tickets. And you need to save up these tickets to use the tank, and you need to save up 10 flight plan tickets. And there's 3 flight plans, and I think you get 1 ticket for every flight plan you do, or you get 3 tickets, ticket stubs for each flight plan you take. It'll cost $15 for a lot of you. And hang on to your ticket stubs. Collect 10 of them, and you'll earn a ride in my tank. Ha 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 ha, you seem happy to hear that. Yeah, that does make sense to get 3 ticket stubs per flight plan, because there are 3 of you in the party. So each one of you gets a ticket, basically. That's how it works. And it is different music, it's not the same music that plays on the train. But the music that plays when you get the tank is really cool. Just to keep the video interesting, I'm going to do all 3 flight plans. I'm not going to spam the same flight plan, just do all 3 of them. But you will have to do an extra one after doing all 3, because you need to do 4 in total to get 10 ticket stubs. So that's going to cost $30 to do this one. Well, luckily we have plenty of money on hand. We've got $416, so we're not going to become broke after doing this. And these are pretty cool, actually. You just get to see all the different locations around the world map. Even places that are, like, you come across towards at the very end of the game, you see, like, towns that you haven't visited yet to this point in the game, so it's kind of cool that they show all this off using the flight plan. Duncan's factory right there. those cooking in the oven, so I'm gonna have to like check those out in a minute, like after I've done all this flight plan stuff. So I'm gonna record after I've eaten. Right, so flight plan C, it costs $45. Yeah, because I set a timer for 55 minutes for those to cook. Let me just put the cheese on them, so. Just gotta wait for them to bake. Well, we had to leave it in there for an hour first, and then take them out after leaving them in there for an hour, then put the cheese on it, and then put it back in for another 55 minutes. That's what I'm doing right now, so. Well, after this 55 minutes is up, I'll be ready to eat. Forward to it, because I haven't eaten much today, actually. All I had was breakfast, and that was toast, and that was it. Just toast. So I'm starving Marvin right now. Alright, that was flight plan C we just did, right? So we should be able to do one more. And after, we'll just do the first one again. I can't hold any more. Wait, I can. I've got free inventory space here. What the hell are you talking about, dude? I've got two. Oh no, you need shoot, you need room for one more. Crap. I don't know what to get rid of here, because I really don't want to get rid of that PSI stone. I've got two PSI stones. Anna's already used this one, so I'm going to toss the one that I've already used. And then just keep the one that I haven't used and give that to Anna, because that makes sense to do that. You don't want to get rid of one that hasn't been used and then keep the one that has been used and not get much out of the one that's been used, you know. So it just doesn't make any sense. Alright, $15, yep. Collect 10 of them and you'll earn a ride in my tank. So this is the last flight plan we'll be doing, and then we'll have 10 ticket stubs ready to ride the tank in the next episode. There's also an Easter egg out in this desert, but I already showed that off in my original Earthbound Zero Mother 1 LP that I did a few years ago, so if you want to check that out, you can. I might show it, depending if I can remember where it is, because I'm not going to look it up on YouTube, which I think I did last time, because I didn't know where it was in the, when I did it the first time, so I had to look it up on YouTube to try and find it. I know it's out there somewhere, but the desert is freaking huge. It's not small. Alright guys, I'm gonna... Wait, no, let's just get in the tank. Yeah. Can we just walk up to it and get in it like that? Or do we have to actually hand in the ticket stubs? Well, let's try talking to him again and see what he wants. No. Okay, let me try using a ticket stub and see if he's happy with that. Oh, you saved 10 ticket stubs. I'll lend you my tank. Ha 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 ha. You sure seem happy. Hell yeah, because now we get to go riding around blasting things up with our cool, new, awesome tank. Alright guys, I'm going to end off the episode here and continue on in the next episode. So in the next episode, let's play Mother 25th Anniversary Edition. We shall be getting into our tank and driving it all the way over to the ruins in the desert, which you saw in the flight plan. In one of them, anyway. So anyway guys, until then, this is NDM, saying thanks for watching. Take everybody to the next video.